DJ Diego's radio show.
He only plays the best music.
This is DJ Diego here, live with DJ Anthony.
We're back again with the evening show, and we're going to be having a special guest here tonight, but I'll let Diego take care of that.
Yeah.
Who is this special guest that's going to be on with us tonight, DJ Diego?
Don, from Las Vegas.
All right, so I believe DJ Diego's going to be giving him a call, and he's going to be giving a live interview with this other DJ, and I'll stay out of the interview, but I'm going to let DJ Diego take care of that, and we're going to go to the phone, and we're going to take care of that call right now, and I'm going to step away from the mic and let DJ Diego take over.
Hold on, Dad. All right, let's call him. Speaker.
Hey, I'm not sure. Hey, Diego.
Hey.
Is that you? Yeah, okay, are you ready?
Yeah, we're on live.
Oh, hey, how you doing?
Good.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
All right. Happy holidays to you and your family. Yeah. So what's going on?
Nothing. Then
well,
I asked you.
Hey, you got me here on the phone, and I guess you wanted to talk about a few things. I just dig the fact that you're over there doing this at 15 years old. That takes a lot of courage, and so I admire that. I started in radio when I was your age, and it's been a blast. Yeah?
Yeah.
So what's going on, man?
Nothing. We have a few questions for you. Tell us about...
Questions for me? Oh, cool.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
My life has been a journey, Diego, and I tell you, man, I've been in radio for a number of years, but if you want to know a little something about me, I'm just like the average guy, got a wife and kids and trying to live the American dream, and just pretty much just your normal next-door kind of guy, you know, I guess. If you're asking where I'm from, maybe, I'm from Southern California, the San Fernando Valley, and, yeah, that's too far away from home. Right now, I'm in Las Vegas, and, yeah, it's a fun place to live. So, yeah, that's about it.
Got another question.
What got
you into DJing?
Well, what really got me into broadcasting and to DJing? There's two different kinds of DJs, and you got your mobile DJ, which does, you know, your parties, and then you got the on-air personalities, what they call them now. And so I did a little both, but what got me into radio was I started as a mobile DJ. I started doing backyard parties, and my love for music has always been there since the time I was little. I played drums, and I've always loved music, and so when I got into DJing, it was very cool. You know, I used to get on the microphone and DJ at the same time, and I said, man, this is me. I bet you I can get on the radio and try that and see if that is, you know, there's a career. You can't make a whole lot of money being a mobile DJ, but if you get into broadcasting, you become very successful at it, and you work in a big market like L.A. or New York, you can make a nice living. Chances of that happening are very hard because only the select few get to make it to those big markets, and they're like, you know, Ryan Seacrest, who has replaced Rick Dees at 102.7 Kiss FM in LA, or, you know, some of these other guys, Nick Tanner, who used to be married to Mariah Carey. He's a DJ in New York. He does mornings. So, but those are the select few, but, you know, I'm not saying that Albuquerque or Houston, Texas, or Cincinnati, or some of these other smaller places is a good place to work in radio. it's just, you got to do it for the love of it. Is what I'm saying. If you're one of the lucky ones and make it to the top, hey, be more power to you. But back to your question is, what got me in radio? I went on a field trip when I was probably about 13. I went on a field trip and I got to meet Rick Dees at 102.7. You know, when I walked into the studio and I seen what he did and the environment that he was around and just the whole atmosphere, I said, you know what, I want to do that. That is cool. And so that was what really set it off for me. And then being a mobile DJ and everything, just the love for music, that was my passion, yeah. So, you know, that's really what motivated me to get into radio, was that field trip.
Okay, we got question number three. How old were you when you started to DJ?
Well, you know, Diego, I was your age. And that's why you remind me so much of me. I used to do a show at Cal State Northridge on the weekends. And it's something that I look forward to every week. I plan my whole week. I thought, what am I going to play or what am I going to say? So I had a whole week to do that. In fact, when I was supposed to be doing my homework, that's all I was thinking. Is I was thinking all that. All the time, constantly, was in my mind. So that's how I started. And then after that, I got lucky enough to be able to start as a board operator there and working part-time. It was on a volunteer basis. So I volunteered a lot of my time when I first started in radio. And I did that for about 2 years. Then I went to broadcasting school in L.A. and got fundamentals and some of the theology and the science behind broadcasting, which there is. There's a science behind it. So, you know, you got to learn how to do production and you have to learn how to cut commercials and you have to know how to articulate on the air, because if you do make it to the big time, you can't be stuttering and you can't be slipping up and making mistakes. It's live. You only got one shot at this. You got to sound really good. So I went to broadcasting school for a few years. For a few months. And then I worked in Albuquerque for a couple of years. Albuquerque, New Mexico, I worked in radio for about two different radio stations, actually. Then I came here to Vegas and worked in radio in Vegas for a couple of years. And so, yeah, it's been off and on, but yeah. I hope that answers your question.
Huh? What, number four, what are the pros and cons of being a DJ?
Well, the problem of it is that you get to go to work and you get to enjoy what you do, and I can tell if you'll make it to the number one markets, you don't get paid a whole lot of money. It's a lot less than what people think it is. Those that are on television probably make five times the amount of those on radio. But the problem is it's something that you enjoy. But the negative part about it is it's a very competitive career. And so you got to watch out who are your friends and who are for you and who are against you, because if you do make it, then there's going to be a lot of those that want your job. They're going to do whatever they got to do to get it. Trust me. Yeah. So,
okay.
You got to watch yourself. Yeah.
Okay, and number five, how was the technology played a role?
Oh. It's... in 1984, we were using turntables and cart machines. And if you did something like what you're doing now, we had to record it on what they call reel-to-reel. It's the old reel where you have to cut tape off and splice it and put it back together to edit, to take out the parts. But now, the technology is just, it's all digital. It's unbelievable. You don't need any of that. Everything is all loaded in. The software is in a computer. You don't have to use the old vinyl or the turntables, the albums. You don't have to reload the commercials into a cart machine. You don't have to splice tape. It's all right there in a computer. So technology has definitely changed. And the cool thing about podcasting, what you're doing, is that you're heard all over the world, as if you were right next door down the street on FM radio. I would have never thought when I was your age that any of this could have been possible. So it didn't change quite yet. As an on-air personality from the old school, I wish it was still back the way it was when I first started. That was real radio, because you had to really work for it. You had to queue up those records and make sure everything was ready. Now, you could leave the studio for 20 minutes and put it on autopilot and let it run by itself. And so much is consolidated that you can't just advocate from the programming. You can't just play what you want. You have to play what is there and already pre-programmed. You have to say exactly what they want you to say, and you can't deviate from that. So very strict today. Very strict.
Yeah.
You answered all your questions, young man. You know, you're rocking over there playing the best old school. I talked to you the other night podcasting in Diego. You keep up what you're doing because I'm telling you, man, don't let nobody get you down. It's not an easy career, but if you see it through, you're going to love what you do and you're going to get paid for it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you keep rocking. You keep rocking.
And that is it for Diego's radio. So thanks for having you.
Oh, story, but listen, I'm always here for you. You keep up the good work, and I'm telling you, everybody, you can't go wrong with Diego. It's old school. Yeah, it's off the chain, baby.
Yeah.
702 rocks. All right, Diego, you take care. I'll talk to you soon.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow, that was really good.
Yeah, it was really good.
That was a good interview, and we thank Don back in Nevada for doing that for Diego, and it was appreciated. And so we're going to give him a round of applause for his advice and wisdom and all the things that he said. It was just amazing. And so we're going to continue on with the show. Let us get into the music aspect of being here live. We're going to go into an old school track back from the 80s, Ghostbusters. Well, actually, yeah, this is the 80s, late 80s, I believe around 89, somewhere around there. But this is actually Ghostbusters 2 theme song by Run DMC. And again, that was an excellent, excellent, excellent interview. And Diego, I thought you did a good job as well. So let's give Diego a round of applause. All right, we're going to go into Ghostbusters by Run DMC.
All right.
Get it done.